With us again. Thanks. Again, that's a Washington Post op-ed. I want to bring in the panel, Dana Bashir, Effie Tubin, Alan Dershowitz, Gloria Borger, Kirsten Powers, and Philip Mudd. It is interesting. It's fascinating to hear from Tony Schwartz.
Can I just say, you know, Jane Mayer, my colleague at The New Yorker, did a piece with Tony Schwartz before the campaign. It was when Tony sort of first...
Right, publicly.
Campaign. And it, I mean, his insights into Trump's character are so amazing. And you know, I think that interview... undoubtedly whetted people's appetite. The Washington Post op-ed piece, Jane's piece in The New Yorker. Yeah. I mean, this guy really knows Trump better than almost anybody who's written about
him. We shouldn't overstate some of the psychological things. I think it goes a little too far to say that every insult he throws really is looking at himself in the mirror. We have to be very careful in kind of psychologizing
right. somebody. Well, although there is a pattern to the insults that he gives to other people, and it does, after a while, make you wonder, why are these, like, why is winning such
but
a big...
if you listen to him, you would think this guy would have ended up in a bankruptcy court somewhere.
Actually, no. I actually think...
And not being a very great success.
I actually think the opposite. I think most people who attain a great level of success are actually pretty unhappy, and you know, it comes from a deep place of, like, longing and need. And I speak from someone who's, you know, relatively successful.
Anderson, would you like
again, maybe I'm speaking about myself.
But you're speaking about us, too. So
well, you know. Yes. Sorry, go ahead.
Anderson, there's one other interesting thing that, of course, Tony Schwartz wrote about in the book The Art of the Deal, because he had to come up with a way, he says, and he's written about this and talked to us about it, to describe the president's, let's call it, special relationship with the truth. And he called it truthful hyperbole, which is his way, as he says, of figuring out how to say Donald Trump was lying, which he did quite frequently, without saying that he was lying. And when he presented it to Donald Trump and said, well, look, this is the way I'm going to talk about you, and I'm going to say you engage in truthful hyperbole, Trump thought this was a great idea, that this was the best thing that he had ever heard, and he kind of gave him a rationale for not telling the truth, for which I think Tony feels forever regretful.
We should also say, the president is also charming one-on-one, and I enjoy talking to him, as I think many people who do interview him do enjoy talking to him. But Kirsten, in terms of what's happening now, and political transgressions are not necessarily legal transgressions, Robert Mueller's job is not to parse President Trump's qualities as a leader, but you can expect members of Congress are obviously going to continue to try to do that.
Right, but I think that this is a really important point to remember, is that telling the truth is actually really important when you're under investigation and you're put under oath. Because if you look back to what got President Clinton ultimately in trouble, it was perjuring himself. Mm-hmm. When you look back to what ultimately got Scooter Libby, it was two perjury counts, you know, and an obstruction of justice account as well. So I think that the fact that President Trump often does, I think what Tony Schwartz said, the invention of stories, I would say he maybe doesn't always remember things exactly the way that they happened. We could think of Inauguration Day would be a good example of that, where he kept insisting that the crowds were a certain size when they weren't. And when you're put under oath and you start having problems telling the truth, I think that you can get into a lot of trouble. You also have a White House that I don't think anyone would accuse of being run like a well-oiled machine necessarily, and that's not even I'm not trying to be critical, it's a new White House, who are now going to be thrust in the middle of an investigation where you have to have all your ducks in a row, you have to answer all these questions so honestly and so clearly, and you do wonder what kind of problems could come out of this just from them not answering those questions.